Okay guys, so today we start our examples for CNC programming GNM code. So let us take a look at our first example. Our first example relates to a problem. This is the problem which is given in the book as an example. It has been solved already. However, we for the sake of learning, we will solve together in the class so that if anybody has any confusion about the application of any G or M code, then he or she can ask me in the class. So together we are going to solve this problem. So here in the problem, as you guys can see, we have got a machining part, and this is a part that we need to machine. In this part, we need to drill three holes, number one, number two, number three hole, and then we need to mill, if you can see, we need to mill the outer periphery. So laser pointer, so we need to mill the outer periphery. Okay, so this is a straight line. Straight lines means we need to apply straight line interpolation or linear interpolation. Then from here to here is also straight line, so we need to apply linear interpolation. Then from here until here is a curve, so we need to apply circular interpolation. Okay, and after that we have to go straight again, linear interpolation, and then again linear interpolation. So we have two types of operations that are required to be performed. Number one is drilling of three holes, number one, number two, number three, and number two, second operation is the milling of the outer periphery. So for applying these two operations, let us take a start with drilling three holes. So in order to drill holes, we need to first know the dimensions of the holes, okay, which are given in the diagram, as well as we need to know what is the position of the holes with respect to origin. So as you can see in the diagram, the position of the holes with respect to origin is given. Our origin is 0, 0, and our hole number one is located at 70 millimeters x-axis and 30 millimeters y-axis. Similarly, our hole number two, this is hole number two, let's say it is located at 120x and 30y, and our hole number three is located 70x and 60y. So what I want to do is, first I need to position the tool. So I will position a tool which is little bit away from the workpiece. So my objective number one is bring the tool near to the workpiece, but don't touch the workpiece. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to bring my tool. Let's assume that this laser pointer is my tool. So I'm going to bring my laser pointer and the tool towards the workpiece, and then I will make it stay there. Okay. We need to be precaution, and we need to take precaution that the tool does not touch the workpiece initially. Once my tool is nearby, then I will tell the tool to go to this point and move. Okay, once I tell the tool that it should move, then it will move from the first place until this place. Okay, after it has reached the hole number one, then I will give the instructions for the tool to go down and start drilling. So this is how we are going to move on with the drilling steps. So let's take a look at the problem. What does the problem say, and what is the given data in the problem? So as you can see in example 7.1a, point to point drilling, it means we are going to use motion control system, which is point to point. So motion control system, MCS, is going to be point to point system. Okay. Now, in order to solve the problem, we need to gather the data. What is the data which is given in the problem? It is important and essential to write the given data in the form of the heading given data. So if you are going to write in the exam this heading given data, then you are going to get marks for this as well, because what you are doing is you are reading the problem and getting the information from the problem. You are analyzing, and you have started the process of analyzing the problem. That is why it is important to solve the problem systematically. So number one is given data. What is given data? Let us see in the problem. So this problem states that this example presents the NC part program in word address format. Okay, in word address format for drilling three holes. So I have to drill three holes. Okay. The outside edges of the starting work part have been rough cut by a jigsaw and are slightly oversized by subsequent profile milling. The three holes to be drilled in this example will be used to locate and fixture the part for profile milling in the following example. For the present drilling sequence, the part is gripped in place so that its top surface is 40 mm above the surface of the machine tool table. So this part is basically gripped so that its top surface is 40 millimeter above the machine tool. So the machine tool is around about 40 millimeter above. This provides ample clearance beneath the part for hole drilling. So currently the position is that our part is on lying on the bed and the machine tool is quite far away. And the vertical distance between them is 40 millimeter. Okay. This is my tool. This is my work piece or work part. Okay. The X, Y, and Z axis are defined as shown in figure P7A.4.A. So if we go back, then X, Y, and Z axis are shown. So X, Y, and Z axis are shown like this, X and Y. Okay. Next, a 7 millimeter diameter drill corresponding to the specific hole size has been chucked into the CNC drill press. The drill will be operated at a feed. Feed is given F is equals to 0.05 millimeter per revolution. Okay, and a spindle speed, so S spindle speed is given as 1000 revolution per minute. Okay, corresponding to a surface speed of about 0.37 meter per second. So surface speed is not important, which is slow for aluminium work part material. At the beginning of the job, the drill point will be positioned at a target point located at, so the initial position is given, initial position, initial position coordinates are given, which is x is equals to 0, y is equals to minus 50 and z is equals to plus 10. Okay, which are specified, the units specification is millimeters. The program begins with the tool position at the target point. So we need to start the program so that the tool has been positioned at the coordinates which are given. So let us start writing the NC program. Okay, so let's move forward. So I will remove the solution. Let's start ourselves. Okay, so we need to have G and M codes with us also. So please open G and M code separately in your laptop so that it is easier for you guys to start the programming. So I will open G and M code separately also. Okay. So what should we do first? First of all, we need to tell computer that I am going to give you order in millimeters, not in inches. Okay, this is the first order that I need to give. So if you want to give this order, then open your table, open your G and M code table, go to table 7A.2 and see where it is written that I should give the orders in millimeter. So go to G number 21, G21 code, and you can see that input value specified in millimeter. So now I will use this code and tell machines everything from now on will be in millimeter. So let's write our sequence number 1. So let's write N01. This is my line number 1. Okay. First thing is I need to tell the machine, okay, you have to do everything in millimeter. G21. Everything in millimeter. Okay. Then what I need to do is I need to specify what are the coordinate system which I am going to use, whether it is absolute or incremental. Okay, so it is up to the students which coordinate system they want to use, which coordinate system they are happy with. Okay, in the book they have used absolute system. So if you want to use absolute system, then go to the G and M code table, G code table, and see where it is written absolute system, coordinate system. So if you can see, coordinate systems are given as G90 and G91. So if you want to use G90 for absolute, then use G90. So I will be using G90. So G90 is the coordinate system absolute. ABS absolute coordinate system. Okay, now I have told the machine that I will give you the order in millimeter. I have told the machine you need to listen to me based on absolute coordinate system. Now I want the tool to move near to the machine, but don't touch it. I want the tool to move to the coordinates which have been defined in the problem. Okay. So in order to make the tool move, we need to tell and give interpolation, whether it is going to move straight or it is going to move in circular. So I want to give movement order to the tool. Okay, so in order to give movement order to the tool, you can see just a second, G90. Okay, so now I need to tell the machine the coordinates which have been given. So in order to specify coordinates, you can go to the G code table and see G92. Okay, G92 has been given. Specify location coordinate axis relative to the starting location of the cutting tool used in milling and drilling. So now I have to tell the machine, please follow this coordinates. Okay, so I will be writing G92. So G92, specify location of the coordinate axis system, origin. So my origin coordinates are given. What they were given, you can see here, initial position coordinates are given. So let us write these in G and M codes. Okay, so X is 0. You have to write everything in capital words. Y minus 50 and Z 10. Okay, it is written in the book 0 minus 50 0 50.0 10.0, but it's up to you guys, it's not a matter. So I have now given coordinates. Okay, so coordinate established, millimeter established, absolute system is established. Now let's move over to the hole. Let's move the tool to the hole. Okay, so in order to move the tool to the hole, let's write the second sentence. So N02. Okay, so how to move the tool? Last lecture I told you guys, G00, G01, G02, G03 in the table are all related to movement of the tool. Okay, G00 is point to point movement, immediately move towards that point. Okay, so now I am not doing any milling, I just want the tool to move towards the hole. So I will give G00 point to point movement. So I will use here G00. Point to point movement, but where, which place? So give us the coordinate of the hole number 1. So coordinates of the hole number 1 are x 70, y 30. Okay. Noting because there is no change in the z direction, so there is no need to specify z again. So you can just write x and y only, because x and y are changing only. So x is 70, y 30. Okay, G00 means point to point, P to move point to point movement. Now my tool is right above the hole. Let's start the spindle. Let's specify the feed unit. Let's specify the feed rate, and then tell the tool to move downwards and start drilling. Okay. So in order to do that, let's go to sentence number 3. N03. Okay. So now when I go to sentence number 3, I have to do G01 linear interpolation, then we have G95. G95 is specify feet per revolution in milling. Okay, and then I will write the feed, and then I will write the spindle speed, and then I will start the spindle. Okay, so let's tell the tool, okay, that you have to move downward. Okay, and but before that we need to specify feed. So I will write the feed first. I will write G, I will specify the feed unit first. Our unit of feed is millimeter per revolution, as given in the given data, millimeter per revolution. So let me go to the table and see G95 is feed millimeter per revolution. So I will write the code G95 first. I wrote G95 first. Now I want to specify the feed, amount of feed. Okay, so how much is the amount of feed? 0.05. okay, what is the code for feed? So you go to the table number A7, table number 7A1. Okay, so in order to specify feed, what is the, how to specify feed? Go to table 7A.1 in the book chapter or in the slides, and you can see that for specifying feed we have the word F, and then in front of F we need to write the feed rate. Okay, so now I have already defined the unit with the help of G95. So G95 is feed unit. After specifying the feed unit, I will tell the feed rate. So I will write here F, how much is the feed rate? 0.05 millimeter per revolution. So 0.05. okay. Then I want to start the spindle. Okay, and I want to specify how much is the spindle speed. Okay, so go once again to table 7A.1 and see how to specify spindle speed. So the unit for specifying the spindle speed is, or the word is S. Okay, and spindle speed is given in revolution per minute. revolution per minute. So I will go back to my question given data, okay, and I will see that the spindle speed is given in revolution per minute. Okay, so I will go down again for my program and I will write S1000. Specify spindle speed S1000. Okay. Then I have specified that I have given the machine the input of spindle speed. Now I want to start the tool. So I will start the tool by giving the action order. Action order is usually M code. So action, take action using M code, start spindle. Okay, I will start the spindle. So what is the code for start spindle? M03 and M04. Okay, so M03 or M04, which code should we use? So I will go back to the problem and I will see how do we want to start the spindle, clockwise or anti-clockwise. So the spindle speed is 1000 revolution and the clockwise direction is not given. So it is not mentioned whether clockwise or anti-clockwise. So you guys can assume any value. For the sake of simplicity, let's assume M03, which is clockwise direction spindle speed. So I will go back and I will start M03. So my spindle has started. Now I will tell, now that the spindle has started, the tool is rotating. Now I will tell it to go down and drill. So to move means G01. Okay, I have to make the cutting process while moving down, which is linear interpolation. So for linear interpolation, for moving downwards, if the tool needs to move while moving, it has to move downwards. This is called, it's in straight line. So this is linear interpolation, and the code for linear interpolation is G01. So this is G01. So I will go back to my program and now I will specify G01. I will tell the machine to move. Where to move? It has to move downwards. How much it has to move downwards? That's the question. How much should be the depth of my hole? So let's go back to the problem and see what is the hole dimensions that are required. So it is telling us that we should have the dimension of the hole. How much is the depth? So you can see it is in the diagram. As you can see, we have a through hole and the depth of the hole is 10. Okay. Okay. So I will give machine the instruction that the tool is moving already. Now just go down minus 10. Why minus 10? Because in the diagram, as you can see, this is the zero point. So I want to drill the hole until 10 mm. Okay. So I want the machine to go 10 millimeter below Z-axis. Okay, so this is my workpiece, this is my axis. Okay, At this point we have 0, this is minus 10, this dimension is minus 10. So now I will go and tell you move, and you move in the direction z minus 10. So now the tool has gone down minus 10. Okay, after the tool has gone minus 10 and has done the drilling, I want it to go upward again, go back. So in order to make it go back, I will write another sentence, n03. In order to go back, just linear interpolation go up. So g01 z 010.0. So now it has gone up. Simple. Now I have done the drilling of the hole. Now I want to move to the second hole. Okay, so quickly go to the second hole. So now we will repeat what we have done already. So this was N04, now N05, point to point movement, quickly go to that point. So G00 X one to 0.0 Y is 30 already, so Y is 30 already actually, so no need to mention Y also, I think. I'm moving forward. You can go up also. You can drill hole number one, then you can go up and drill the hole. I'm moving forward. So I want to drill the second hole, which is in front. So I will go in front. Now I will do linear interpolation N00, N06. Now my tool is on top. So I will tell it to go down because spindle is running already. So I will tell it to go down with a feed rate of 0.005. Okay. So N006, G01, linear interpolation. How much? We need to specify feed once again, G95. Okay, specify feed G95. We have to specify feed again and again for every drilling, because feed means drilling process. Then F0.05, then you have to go X is nothing, only Z minus 10. Now it has gone down. Now we need to move back again. So N07, G01, move back Z 10.0, move back. Okay, so this is how we can finish this drilling process. So let's assume that I have done all the drilling. Now I want to stop the program. Okay, so what I will do is I will write the last sentence. Okay, after drilling the hole, I want it to come back to the original position. So point to point G0, come back to the coordinate X0, Y minus 50, and M05. What does M05 mean? Stop spindle. And then I want to finish the program. So N09 is M30. Finish program. So this is how you guys can do programming. Okay. So you guys can copy paste the code also in this simulator. Copy paste the code. There is one mistake which I have done. If somebody can highlight the mistake, I will be very happy. There is a very major mistake I have done. During writing the program, I made a mistake. And the mistake is that I did not put semicolon. Okay. In order to finish the program, sorry, in order to finish every sentence, we have to write semicolon. So remember this, otherwise your whole program will be not able to run. Okay. So let us start the simulation. I will start plot button. Okay, you can see this. Okay. So how the tool is moving? It moves from here, goes down, go up, go to the next hole, go down, go up, go to the next hole, go down, go up, and then it comes back to its original position and the program ends at M30. Okay, so you guys can simulate using software also. So this was all about turning GNM codes. This exercise is about milling machine. Okay, how do we perform milling with the help of GNM codes? So it's a little bit tricky and it's a little bit different. Okay, so let's take a look at the milling NC example and what is the given data. I will solve it only the half part, and the rest of that, the repetitive part, you guys can solve yourself. So the three holes have been drilled already now. Now after solving the previous example, the three holes have been drilled. Okay. And now what I want to do is I want to mill the outside edges. So I have to mill the outside edges of the workpiece. Okay. The coordinates are same as given in the previous example. And the part is fixtured so that its top surface is 40 millimeter above the surface of the machine tool. Okay, a 20 millimeter diameter end mill with 4 teeth is used. So diameter, let's say, I'm not sure whether we need diameter is equals to 20 millimeter. Okay, the cutter has a side tooth engagement length of 40 millimeter. Side tooth engagement length of 40 millimeter. Throughout the machining sequence, the bottom tip of the cutter will be positioned 25 millimeter below the part top surface, which means I have to do cutting, or Z should be equals to minus 25 millimeter. So I have to do the milling minus 25 millimeter. So the depth of the milling should be minus 25. Since the part is 10 millimeter thick, this Z will allow the side cutting edges of the milling cutter to cut the full thickness. So the objective for our milling tool is basically to cut through and all the edges. Okay, so there shouldn't be nothing remain. So that is why it has gone minus 25. Okay, this position will allow the side cutting. Okay. The cutter will be operated at a spindle speed S is given equals to 1000. Revolution per minute, same thing, which corresponds to a speed of 0.02 millimeter per tooth. The tool path, the feed rate is F is equals to 50 millimeter per minute. Okay, the tool path to be followed by the cutter is shown in figure. The numbering of this at the beginning of the cutter will be positioned so the center tip, and I will look at x 50 minus y. So the coordinates, origin coordinates. Origin coordinates are x equals to 0, y is equals to minus 50, and z equals to plus 10. The problems we get with the tool position in this location. Okay, so let us start the problem. Now, if you look at the diagram P7A.5, then this diagram has been written with the help of every single line number. Okay, so for N001, we have it mentioned that N001 means that the tool is in this state, N002 means that the tool is in this position, then N003 the tool moves to this position, N004 means the tool moves to this position. Now, in this program or in this milling process, we need to remember that we have to give cutter compensation also, which in the last lecture we saw or we observed. Okay, why we need to give cutter compensation? Because cutter has certain amount of radius and cutter has to move inside the milling. So this cutter is going to basically move inside the workpiece to do the cutting process. So for that purpose we have to give cutter compensation, and for cutter compensation we have to specify the radius or we have to specify the cutter properties in the codes. Okay, so that is something that we will learn also. So let's do the first thing, which is the first thing to do is specify units. After specifying the units, tell which positioning system we need to use. Okay, whether absolute or incremental. Then we need to specify the origin. So we have to specify G92 for origin. What is the current position? Then we will tell the cutter to move towards the workpiece. Okay, so let's take a start. N001. Okay, so G21 for specify in millimeter. G90 for programming in absolute coordinates. Okay, absolute coordinates, this is millimeter. Now I need to tell the tool coordinates. Okay, so where are the tool coordinates? G92 is used for specify the coordinates axis system relative to the starting location of the cutting tool. The coordinates are given in the problem already, x0 y minus 50 and z 10. So I will write x 0.0, y minus 50.0, z 0.10. And then I will end the use semicolon for ending the line. Okay, now we move on to N002. Now I have to tell that you need to move from this position, from the origin, you have to move from origin towards the workpiece. You have to touch the workpiece now. Okay, not touch, but move so that after you are above you will go down. Okay, so you have to move towards the workpiece. So means point to point movement. You have to move quickly. So for quick movement we have G00. Okay, then where should we move? Okay, we have to move in rapid movement to the cutter depth, turn spindle on. Okay, yeah, this is tricky. Initially this is my workpiece and my cutter is not aligned with the workpiece. The cutter is above. Okay, I want the cutter to move down first, then move towards the object and do milling process. Okay, in drilling what happens, we move towards the location, then we start drilling process. In milling process what happens is that we start the spindle. Okay, and then we move in towards the location from where we need to start the milling machine. So initially at the origin my tool is above. Okay, so now my next point is to make the tool down, start the spindle and then move towards the workpiece. Okay, that is why I want to make the workpiece go down at a height which is specified, minus 25. So this is my tool, this is my workpiece, I want it to go minus 25. So I will mention G00 Z minus 25. Now I want to start the spindle, so I will specify the speed, spindle speed 1000, and start the spindle M03 in clockwise direction. And the sentence ends. So now I am still in this area. N02, I am still away from the workpiece. Now I will make the workpiece move towards the milling machine, and the moment it moves, it will start the milling process. That is why I will use linear interpolation. So N0303 is linear interpolation G01. Okay, so what are the coordinates of G01? We have to move, when we move and we are doing the milling process, then we have to specify the feed and the feed rate unit. So G94 is the feed rate unit, which is in millimeter per minute. So G94, what is the feed given? F is 50. But here in the solution, you can see F is 40. So this is wrong. In the solution, the feed given is 40. Whereas in the problem, if you see, the feed given is 50. So we have to make this correction. And we will write feed is 50. So F50.0. Okay. Next, G94, F50. Okay. Next is G42. What is G42? Cutter compensation. Okay, should be cutter compensation, G42. What happens is that when you have got a workpiece and your cutter has to cut the material, okay, so we need cutter compensation here. That is why we need to have the code G42, which also specifies the radius of the tool also. Okay, because now we are doing the peripheral milling. So we will write here G42, start cutter compensation. And with G42, we have to, why we are using G42, why not 43? The question is, why not G41? So cutter offset compensation left of the part. Okay, if this is my plate, if I am in this region, this is left part. If I am this region, this is right part. So I am moving on the right side of the workpiece. That is why this is G42. Okay, so I will use here G42. How much is the diameter or radius? Okay, we have to use the diameter or radius code. So go to the code of diameter radius. I have the code with me. So the code is cutter radius or nose radius must be specified in the block. Cutter radius must be specified. So cutter radius is how much? Cutter radius will be taken from the machine automatically when I specify D05. Okay, so in table number 7A1, table 7A1, you will see D05 written. Okay. And if I go and check my problem also, the radius, a 20 millimeter diameter means 10 millimeter, 4 teeth will be used, and 40 millimeter will be in cutter position. Since the part is 10 millimeter thick, yes, since the part is 10 millimeter thick, the Z position will be okay. Cutter diameter data has been manually entered in the offset register 05. In the problem, it is given. So I have to write and given data. Cutter offset register 05 is given. Okay. So it means cutter offset register 05 means this is equals to D05. That is why I will write here in the code G42D05, the diameter compensation or the cutter compensation. Okay, next. Now we specify the feed. So feed has already been specified. That's it. And now it is telling to go to Y0. Okay. So G01 is linear interpolation. So I will write here Y0. Move towards Y0. So now I am at this point. Because of cutter compensation, this is the distance I have left. Okay. So I am now at this position. Now I want to move forward. So very simple linear interpolation G01 from here to this part X. How much is the distance of X? X is 160. Okay, 160. So go down and X 160. So N04. G01 X160. Now I am at this position. Now I want to move here until this point. So what is the coordinate of this point before the curve starts? This is also linear interpolation until this point. So this point is from here to here is y is 1 y 70. The distance from here to here is 70. So G00 again N005, sorry, G01, not 00, G01 Y 60. It was 70, why not? Why it is 60? Should be 70. Let me check. Oh, it's 60. Yeah, Y is 60 here. My mistake. So Y is 60. Now I want to do circular interpolation because I want to move in the circular direction. I want to do milling in the circular direction. So I will apply circular interpolation, which will help me do circular milling. Okay. So what is the code for circular milling? You go to the GNM code. Okay. And you see milling, circular milling. Circular milling is circular interpolation clockwise or anti-clockwise. I am moving in this direction, I am moving anti-clockwise. So I will be using G03 circular interpolation counterclockwise. And block must include either arc radius. So I need to mention the arc radius or arc center or coordinates of the end point position must be specified. So I need to mention the radius of the curve and until which point it should stop. Okay. So the final position should be mentioned also. So I will go back to the problem and I need to know what is the radius. Okay. So the radius given in the problem is 30, 30. So R is 30. And the coordinates when it should stop, the tool will stop as which coordinate? X is equals to yeah, so these are the coordinates. So X equals to 130 and Y is equals to the Y direction is 90. So this is given 90. This line is at Y location 90 and this curve will stop at X is equals to 130. Okay. So the coordinates of this area or this position coordinates are X is 130, Y is 90. These are the end coordinates. The radius is also 30. So I will write my program now. N006, G17. What is G17? Go to the table. G17 is XY plane milling. Okay, so whenever you are specifying the milling for the circular interpolation, then you have to specify the plane. So this is XY plane. So if I am going to draw this in three dimensions, okay, then my workpiece is like this. Okay, so my workpiece lies in which plane? This is Y plane, this is Z plane, Z, Y and X. So my tool has to move in the X, Y plane to make the curve. So the plane in which I am working is the X, Y plane. So the G code for X, Y plane, XY plane milling, G code can be seen in the table. So go to table of the G code. And you can see G17 selection of XY plane in the milling. So G17 select G17. Okay, so now I will go back to my program and I will write G17 because I am doing milling in the G17 or in the G series in the XY plane. Okay, so G17, next G03, circular interpolation right side. So G03. Okay, then we have to specify the last point of the milling after the miller will stop the circular milling process. So the last part is X 130.0, Y 90.0, and I need to specify the how much should be the radius. So the radius given in the problem is R is equals to 30. So I will write R030.0 and I will finish the sentence. Okay. So this was the most important point that we need to consider. After this, we have to go to linear interpolation, then again linear interpolation back to the origin, and then go back away from the center and then come back again to the origin. That's it. This is how we solve the milling process safely. So I will not finish the whole numerical, this part program, NC part program, but I will finish until here because this is something that we need to understand. After N006 line, it's straightforward linear interpolation, again linear interpolation, then point to point movement, then point to point movement back to the origin, and then the last but not least, N011 M30, finish the program, stop the spindle. M05 is stop the spindle. That's it. Okay, so this was all about examples of milling and turning G and M codes. 12 students have submitted the assignment. That's very good. So definitely whoever attempts, I will give some marks. I will give them compensation in the test as well. So thank you for submitting the marks. So this is all about G and M codes. You can do the simulation also. You just copy paste this code in the simulation, online, and you can see how the tool moves in the directions. Okay.